Now the question is, can they fight? Can they grab each other?
Oh my gosh, guys, we've got just 1 week until baby goats are born, and we are rushing to finish our new milking parlor. Over the years, we've had a lot of different hodgepodge designs, but today we are finishing the final design, and it's gonna be a fancy one, because when you're squeezing teats twice a day, it's gotta be top notch. Okay guys, welcome to the fanciest milking parlor you've ever seen.
Yes.
Okay, you walk in and then you come over here and you have everything you'd ever want in a milking parlor.
Anything.
We've got a sink.
Running water, just like Swiss Family Ramen.
And then we've got a really cool stainless steel rolling cart that I found for like 25 bucks on Craigslist. Nice. So that's really cool. And we've got a little hot water kettle here for when we need hot water to clean out the milking machine, all the udder cleaning supplies, and of course, a beautiful pot of flowers. Then we've got the milking machine area right here. A person can sit here and be working the machine. And then we've got the two milking stands. It's a twofer, guys. It's a double setup, and I'm so excited. We should try it out and see how it works.
Highly engineered for efficiency. They come in, boom.
Right up the ramp.
They get milked by the milking machine right here. I sit right here, hook them up. And then they eat the little bit there. And then they come over here to the next one. And DaNelle takes out the last little bits while they eat a little more.
We've got such a good plan. And I know what you're thinking. This chair is right in the middle. But this was the only place we could have it. And you guys know me. I need a soft, fancy chair in my milking station.
Yes.
It kind of works because this post is in the way anyway, and those two bins on the end we don't really get into that much, so it should work. It should work. We're gonna try it out. She's like, you don't milk me anymore. Why are we doing this?
He's like, I don't got no milk.
Okay, come on, go up. Look how cool that is. Here you go. Yum. All right, Olive will go up the ramp.
Hey, Olive.
Go up here. Good job. Oh my goodness. Two fat mamas on the stand. Now the question is, can they fight? Can they grab each other? We might have to make something that divides them a little bit. Are you guys good? Not gonna fight? I think they're pretty good. There we go, guys. Cute little butts on the stand. I think this is gonna work. Okay, bye, have a good day. You're looking big. Ooh. Okay, that's it. Keep going, keep going. So the question is, will she do it herself? Will she go down there? Go on. Put your head out and turn around.
She will.
Look at that. All right, guys, there you have it. It only took us a whole month, but at least we're ready in time for kids, because they're gonna come in like a week now. It's getting really close. And when we have kids, we have milk. Right, Olive? Yeah.
Casper! Casper! Yeah!
So we still haven't decided on an official name for the puppy, but we have our two finalists, which are Casper and Remy. So for the next week, we're gonna be calling him Casper. See how it fits. It's my personal favorite.
Okay, we'll try it. We're gonna try it out for a week.
See how it goes.
Are you a Casper or a Remy? Are you a Casper or a Remy? Let's just tell everybody you're gonna be Duke. You look like a Duke.
With all these projects going on, it's been kind of hard to get in the kitchen and get cooking. So I'm really excited that today I have a HelloFresh in my fridge to use. I feel like with cooking, the hardest part isn't all the skills you need to know. It's literally the brain power you have to have, the planning and the prep. Because once 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock hits, if you don't have something ready, it's gonna be a rough night. Today's dish is sort of a spicy southwestern pasta. After sauteing the onions and the peppers in the pan, we add the beef, along with some tomato sauce and some broth. We'll add it to the cooked pasta, along with, of course, cheese and sour cream, to make the perfect southwestern dish. This took like 20 minutes to make, and I swear that life gets easier when you have a HelloFresh kit waiting for you in the fridge. With over 35 weekly recipes, there are plenty of options for your family's favorites. You'll be able to cut back on all that expensive takeout or delivery, and you can skip those last minute grocery runs. To choose your meals and get a HelloFresh box delivered to your doorstep, go to HelloFresh.com and use code WEEDUM21 for 21 free meals plus free shipping. Well, I have some exciting news because we have got our final milk testing results back, and we've got a lot of does that hit their milk testing star. Now, milking stars is a tool us breeders use to help determine if our does are performing according to the breed standard. So when they earn their milking star, it's a good thing. It means that they've met the minimum breed standards, but we're also looking for them to surpass that and do even better. Now, a goat can only earn one milking star in their lifetime, but oftentimes we keep testing so we can see if their production increases and we can see how they match up to all the other does within the breed. But I do have some really exciting news. Daphne hit 87th percentile on her production evaluation, which is so cool. Just to give you a reference, our Tilly is only 22nd percentile compared with all the other Nigerian dwarf does that have been on milk test. So the fact that Daphne is 87th is pretty cool. So basically this means that she has a lot of potential to be really, really strong milking lines and potentially be an elite doe, like her mama. We had 5 does this last year that we milked, and Tilly already hit her milking star a couple years ago, so we didn't need to worry about her as much, but we wanted the new up-and-comers to hit it, and most of them did. So Hazel hit it, and then Daphne, of course, got it, and so did Olive, but unfortunately, little Tatum did not hit the minimum breed standard, which is not a very good sign. So she's on the list as far as, is she gonna be a potential doe that we should keep breeding? But it also could be due to the fact that last year she had a singleton, and that singleton we left on her for a little bit too long. So we probably should have separated earlier and got to milking her so that we could have kept the production up. This year, she's on track to hopefully have twins or triplets, and if she does, then hopefully she'll have a little bit more milk production and a little more stimulus on that udder, so that we can get a little more production out of her and see her reach her full potential. So this pretty much wraps up our year of milk testing, and it's nice to be done, although we're just about to get started again. So all these does have hit their milking star, although Willow is retired, Tilly will soon be retired, and now we need these ones to hit their milking star. But Daphne should get a special award because she did so good. Now, do the goats need these signs? No. But it's fun to be able to keep track of which ones have their stars, which don't. And also we use these to put on the outside of the barn stall when they're delivering their babies. First up is gonna be Tilly in this stall. And let me tell you, she is ready. Just a few more weeks, huh? Get over here. Okay, Ethan, everybody wants to know why you're not at school yet.
Because there's a giant storm up there and our bus was canceled 3 times. So we're driving ourselves.
And school was canceled.
And school was canceled twice.
But now you and Dad are gonna make the trek and you're gonna take the puppy with you, right?
Uh-huh.
No, I don't think so. I don't think puppy would do good on a 5-hour trip. That would be.
He's growing so fast. I think he's gained 5 pounds already.
Yeah.
Ethan goes to school at NAU in Flagstaff, and it's one of the snowiest areas in the country. If you didn't know that,
I didn't know that. I guess they got this crazy snowstorm, school's been canceled, but finally they can head up there, so it'll be good. He's gonna go back to school for his spring semester and it'll be just Kevin and me and Lydia for the next few months. Ethan is majoring in ecology and evolutionary biology, something to do with animals. No! He may be a zoologist, he may be a wildlife conservationist, he's not really sure yet. So it's funny how the animal loving has been inherited